Good morning, family. My name is Tayshawn, and I'm a fourth grader at the University of Dreams. Today is Sunday, January 10th, and this is your Rickie's for the day. When you confront as a Christian, you should speak the truth in love. When I use the word confront, I don't mean that you should be vicious or mean-spirited. If you can't relay it in love, don't say it. Pastor Rickie G. Rush. Sometimes it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Check this out.
Do not run in my hallway!
Boy, if I see you running this hallway again, I will tie your feet together.
I know you're trying to get somewhere, but no running in the hallways. Now let's turn around and try it again.
Yes, sir.
Remember, family, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Let's make sure to watch our tone.
Aw, oh, man. I've got to get this report to my editor.
What am I gonna do?
I know. Control Alt Delete. Reset. That'll do it.
Good morning, IBOC family. It's Sunday, January 10th, 2021. What a time we had in 2020. But here at U of D and IBOC, we're not focused on the past, but on the future. We are reset, renewed, and ready to restart. We're starting off the new year right. Here are a few trending topics. Check it out.
It's a brand new year and it's a brand new opportunity to let God use us in a new way. So here are your trending topics for the week from U of D and IBOC.
Number one, U of D Reset.
Our amazing teachers and staff were prayed up and ready to go this week as we reset for a new semester at the University of Dreams. We love our scholars, and here is a super duper first grade scholar who loves his school.
My name is Aiden. My school is amazing, my teacher is amazing, my friends are amazing, and Pastor Rush is amazing, everybody is amazing in my school, and I just want to say U of D is the best place ever in this whole entire world.
Number two, the World Wide Wall.
Even if you can't be in the building, you can still be in the building. No, we are not together like we used to be, but our amazing tech team has given us a virtual congregation on the walls of our church. That's what I'm talking about.
Number three, Deacon Lynn does it again.
The Cedar Hill Longhorn football team played a semifinal game against Denton Geyer, and they won again. The score was 27-17, and next Saturday at noon, Coach Lynn and the Longhorns will play for the state championship at AT&T Stadium.
It wouldn't be Texas high school football if it wasn't Cedar Hill and Katy, you know, and that's what it's all about. Those rivalries, those matchups should be rather interesting. So we're gonna try to put together another week and see if we can pull one out for the city of Cedar Hill. So we're excited.
Good job, Deacon Lynn. One more to go, and those are your trending topics.
And all the glory goes to God.
Well, that's all we have for this week on IBOC. Make sure to tune in to Monday School tomorrow at 7 p.m. for another practical and powerful word from God. I'm Carson, and you've been watching IBOC. Bye!
Good morning, IBOC family. I'm Sister Brown, a proud teacher here at the University of Dreams, and today, fifth grade is going to show you how to handle Satan's attacks.
Pastor Rush teaches us that because we are Christians, Satan will throw his hardest attacks.
but because God is with us, He will strengthen us and sustain us.
It's our job to believe that God will do what He says He will do.
So check out this example of how you should handle attacks.
This is a regular bag with regular water.
No tricks.
The bag represents you. The water represents your faith.
The pencils represent the fiery darts that Satan throws at us.
So what are some of these fiery darts?
Sickness and depression. Worry and defeat.
Fear and stress.
COVID-19 and unforgiveness.
All of these weapons may form, but they don't have to prosper. Watch what happens next. As you can see, the bag is not leaking. However, when we release a pencil, the bag begins to leak. Have you lost your connection with God? Have you built a wall between you and Christ? Have you just simply stopped praying? The good thing about the God we serve is that He's willing and able to always fill that void. I'm Sister Brown, we're fifth grade, and this is Spiritual Science.